Hello, and welcome to this how-to video of Controlix Developer. This video will show how you can easily create your own HMI solution for Controlix automation. To create our HMI app, we will use the partner app WebIQ from Smart HMI, which is available in our Controlix App Store. To find that there, you have to navigate to the Controlix world. This will lead you to our Controlix automation microsite, and from there you can navigate to the App Store, which contains a bunch of apps provided by Bosch Rexroth and also by our partners for varieties of engineering and automation tasks based on Controlix. And if you have a look at the App Store at the moment, we see two apps from Smart HMI. One is the server app, which will be installed on the Controlix, and the according engineering tool, which is the WebIQ Designer. By clicking the link, you get directly to an information page, which provides some additional information about the company and the app, so to let you know what it's about. And here, you can also directly download both apps, which is the server and also the designer. So now that we have downloaded the app from the App Store, let's install it on the Controlix device. We do that like just other apps you know already. We go to the App Zone. Then we have to switch to service mode. Then we will copy the app to the local storage. And now, as we have downloaded it, it's ready to install. Let's install it. Okay, it says that it was installed successfully. Let's check. And here we go. To create a project for the app we installed just a moment ago, we need also to provide the according engineering tool, which is the WebIQ Designer. This is a Windows application which can be installed directly on your Windows PC. I won't have to install it here because I've done that yet, but if you install it, I recommend to keep the default settings unchanged. And after installation, the program will be available as a shortcut on your desktop. But to tell the designer about the Controlix instance and the app which is installed there, we need to provide some additional start parameters to the shortcut. So we'll do that here. We have this shortcut here, which calls the designer. And by modifying the properties, the target, it's required to provide additional information about the control and the web port. So we'll provide this information here. We have two parameters. One is the host, which is a local host in my case, and we have the port under which the app we installed on the Controlix will be available. This is 10.1.2.3 by default. Now, when we have done that, we are ready to create our first HMI project. Now, as we have installed all the required apps on the Controlix and also the designer on our Windows PC, we can start to create our first HMI app. So we'll start designer to do so. It will request me to log in. The password is Bosch Rexroth by default. But of course, it's recommended to change this password after your first successful login. So this is how the dashboard looks like in an empty installation, and we won't go into the details of WebIQ here. WebIQ, as mentioned several times, it is an app of our partner Smart HMI, and I would invite you to visit their homepage, where you get a bunch of live demonstrations for different types of applications. They have a detailed product documentation there with all the features, both on the, for the runtime and on the server. And they also have some tutorial videos which guide you through your first detailed HMI project with WebIQ. We, in our example, we will focus on the specific attributes and the considerations for using WebIQ on ControlX. And to do so, we will create our new project. Let's say this will be my first ControlX project. We will take this default name. A description can leave it empty. We can need to provide some user settings. Let's say I am the HMI engineer. My default password. So now it's creating the app in the designer. So here we go. Now we have the app created. We see different types of what they call managers for the different kinds of commissioning tasks with a typical HMI project, but we will start with the process data manager, for the IO manager, to connect the our designer to our OPC UA server. So let's create an entry. So we'll have to provide the endpoint here, which is standard. I will use standard Bosch Rexroth account here. But of course, in a final application, you should choose something different. And if I apply, now it tries to talk to the OPC UA server. To allow the WebIQ to talk to our OPC UA server, we need to trust the application in our system. That means we have to jump back to the ControlX and there go to certificates and keys. And there for the OPC UA server, we have a separate slot. And now we see that the WebIQ server tried to talk to our OPC UA server, and we have to trust the certificate one time. And in subsequent starts, the WebIQ app will be considered as trusted app, so there won't be any restrictions in further communications between the OPC UA server and WebIQ. So going back to the WebIQ designer, if I now make a test in the process data manager, I have this browse button up here. And if everything did turn out well, I am able now to browse our OPC UA server. We can see the data layer. Which provides the information also about our PLC app. And if I jump back to to the ControlX just to check. We see the same browsing structure here. For example, and what I can do now, I can select all the variables from the data layer within this integrated browser and then assign the items here to my HMI variables in my HMI project. To use ControlX information in my HMI project, I first have to create an according variable, which I can do to browse the data layer, select a variable, and by right-click, create an according WebIQ variable. Okay, this might be sufficient for now. As you can see, now the variable with the according data layer path has been created in the WebIQ project. Now let's go to the Layout Manager. And select a widget so that I can see the content of my variable. I choose a text display, add this to my project. Up here, we have the widget, and in the configuration, I now can select an according data item. And at the bottom, it's my new created variable, which is directly linked to the data layer. And if I hit apply, I can see the value of my variable inside this label. So let's save the project and go back to the overview page to transfer the project to the ControlX. I have to publish my project to the runtime system, which is the ControlX in my case. So let's do that. So now the app is published, and there's only one last step to make it run. To go to the project list again and select my project and then start the project. Now this will send a command to the WebIQ runtime on the ControlX core and start the project. So to see the project, we have to connect to the control and to the port. If you recall, these are exactly the parameters you had to provide to the WebIQ designer. This is the host, which is localhost in our case, and the port, which is 10.1.2.3 by default. And now if I select my app name, and hit enter, then it comes up with the WebIQ runtime. I have to provide my username and my password. And here we go. On the top, you see a very, very simple HMI, which displays the variable, the content of the variable I selected in the data layer browser. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it was helpful for you. If you have any comments or suggestions, please comment them below.